My name is Hope Michelsen. I'm an associate professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering and in the Environmental Engineering program. I study soot. I study it from basically its whole life cycle, from the time it's born in a combustor, so in a flame or a candle or something, through its emission to the atmosphere and where it ends up. And the reason I study it is because it has very wide-ranging implications for health, for environment. And what's really interesting is that everyone is familiar with soot, but we don't know how it's formed. It's fascinating that something so close to us, something that has an impact on every single person on this earth, is so ubiquitous and we just don't know how it's formed. I actually am a physical chemist by training. I studied gas surface interactions, which in a way really does have a lot to do with soot and how it's grown. As a postdoc, I just switched careers and I went and studied atmospheric science. So I studied the ozone hole. And then when I went to find a job, I found this position at Sandia, and they said that they would hire me if I studied soot. And I was like, heck, you know, that sounds kind of interesting. I don't know anything about it. And it seemed like it put together a lot of my interest in a way I'd never anticipated. When someone says soot, you don't really think, oh, that's so cool. But now it actually really is cool. What's really beautiful about soot is that these little particles are kind of attached together in these really interesting structures. But it's also the particles that come out of trucks that are going down the highway. If you see trucks coming, you know, black stuff coming out of the stacks, that's soot. If you see someone smoking, you'll see soot coming out of that. If you look in your fireplace, you'll see soot. It's actually pretty much everywhere. Wildfires are getting more and more common. So living in parts of the world where you walk outside and you have combustion emissions, it has an impact on your lungs. It has an impact on your heart. It has an impact on your brain. In addition to the fact that it's number two or three behind CO2 for climate forcing. It's one of the most important components in the atmosphere for climate. So if we stopped producing it, then we would be able to prevent it from lingering in the atmosphere. And that would have a lot of positive impacts on human health, the air quality, and climate change. But it's not all bad. Sometimes we want to make soot. It has enormous industrial applications. So every rubber thing you see has soot in it. I think it's close to a $12 billion industry in the US alone, generating soot. There are two parts of my program. One part is a combustion portion where we study both soot formation and chemistry and soot diagnostics. How do you measure not only the particles, like particle size, but how do you measure their composition? And we also use X-ray diagnostics, where we have a component of our research that we, you know, basically go into the field to a synchrotron or to a free electron laser and make measurements that we can't make in our lab here. And then the other part of my research program is environmental, where we're really interested in what happens to soot when it gets into the atmosphere. How do you measure it? Can you measure it under conditions where there's not a lot of soot or the particles are very small, like up in the Arctic? What's going to get transported up there are tiny particles that are going to live a little bit longer, get lofted up high in the atmosphere and transported to high latitudes, and it's hard to measure those particles. We've been working on trying to understand the very first steps of soot formation and what are the species that have an impact and are involved in soot formation in the very first steps. There are other huge questions, like once the first particles are formed, how do they grow so fast? How do they evolve to go from when they first are formed, they're maybe liquid, we don't know, but they are transparent. And you know that when you look outside, when you look at soot coming out of a flame, it's black. So it evolves, all its characteristics evolve. We really don't know the chemistry of how that happens. There's a lot to look at. It's just like kind of boundless.